Deepening reform is vital for China. It is one of President Xi Jinping's four comprehensives, his overarching guidelines for governance. When reform began around 1980, special economic zones, such as Shenzhen, were the pioneers, with special policies to attract foreign capital and utilize China's cheap labor in building an export-driven economy. Now that China has reached the new stage of its remarkable development, more sophisticated kinds of reforms are needed. One of the new pioneers is the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone. There is excitement about the concept, but uncertainty about its practicality. How does the Shanghai Pilot FTZ work? What are its policies? What are its benefits? What is being learned? We go to Shanghai, Pudong, to the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone to get closer to China.
After the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone was set up in September 2013, people from across China flocked to the zone's service center to register companies. The reason is that the Chinese government decided to make the Shanghai Free Trade Zone a pilot for streamlining administration, increasing transparency, and further opening up. The definition of a free trade zone, or FTZ, is a geographic area where goods may be imported and landed from abroad, handled, manufactured, or reconfigured, and then re-exported without the intervention of customs authorities. In addition, the Shanghai Pilot FTZ is experimenting with a series of reforms and innovations to facilitate doing business. For example, the Shanghai FTZ provides a one-stop service center for business startups. Registration of a company can be completed within only 4 days. To streamline administration, the Shanghai FTZ is an online working platform to share information about enterprises among various government departments. This saves enterprises from the time-consuming hassle of visiting different government agencies to provide information for supervision purposes. All these reform policies reduce the cost of doing business, and in the process, accelerate the transformation of government by making it more efficient. Zhu Ming is the deputy director of the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone Administration. He's responsible for industry, science and technology, commerce, foreign capital, trade and shipping. He also acts as the media spokesperson of the administration.
当时在浦东新区开发开放的时候，当时的我们的市长朱镕基先生就提出了要在浦东建设一个类似的自由区的这样的一个总体的方案。那么随着这个改革开放和浦东开发的不断的推进，我们离这个目标越来越近了。那么刚好我们又碰到了全面深化改革和中国进一步对外开放的需要，所以说上海自由贸易试验区就应运而生了。
What is the background on the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone, and how does it fit into China's overall reform?
那么这一轮的就是那个所谓的后WTO时代的，就是那个国际经贸关系的那个谈判呢，它的规则基本上是切入到经济治理的这么一个深层次的。因此呢，我们就设置了那个自由贸易试验区。自由贸易试验区呢，它的一个功能就是通过就是我们主动的开放，就是对主动对接国外的一些市场化的、国际化的一些
制度和那个规则和那个一些个措施一些个做法，然后呢通过这样的推进我们国内的改革。
Many people have a misunderstanding of the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone because they compare it to the special economic zones that were built particularly in Shenzhen starting in the 1980. How would you compare the similarities and the differences between the original special economic zones which really catalyzed all of China's remarkable economic growth and the new pilot free trade zones, Shanghai and now the other three.
如果你是这样比较呢，我觉得呢，相同点的话，那么它都是改革开放的产物，都是在完成特定历史时期的改革开放的任务。如果说不同的话，那么就是它是在不同的历史环境下。深圳是一九八几年，那么我们现在自贸试验区是在我们国家已经在改革开放上面取得的很大的成绩之上，我们在进一步的深化改革和深化开放的一个重大的举措。
Without doubt, China is more open than ever. From 1949 to 1978, the number of citizens who have traveled abroad was under 300,000. In 2014 alone, Chinese citizens traveling internationally exceeded 100 million.China's share of the world exports rose from less than 1% to over 12%, making China the largest export economy. China's transformation began in 1978. Then Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping made it clear that reform and opening up will be the guiding principle of China's economy. 2 years later, special economic zones were established in four coastal cities, Shenzhen, Zhuhai, Shantou, and Xiamen.To attract foreign investment, these zones enjoyed favorable tax rates and cheap land resources. After touring Shenzhen in 1984, Deng Xiaoping was encouraged to increase the scale of the trial. By 1988, China's open area included almost 300 cities or counties, covering a population of more than 200 million. In 1990,China decided to open up the Shanghai Pudong area to try innovative reforms and enhance the outward-looking economy.
So agrees.
In 2001, China joined the World Trade Organization, boosting China's trade volume. By 2013, China became the largest economy in merchandise trade. When in 2013 the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone was established,It marked the beginning of a new era of China's opening up. In December 2014, China decided to expand the free trade zone concept and established three new free trade zones in the provinces of Guangdong and Fujian and the municipality of Tianjin.
Well, I think there's been a bit of misunderstanding about the Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone and then the follow-on ones that have been created.These zones are actually very, very different from the special economic zones that were created in the Southeast Coast in the early 1980s. Those were much more focused on export processing, an enclave where foreign firms could come in, set up, produce products partly with imported parts and components and then sell them onto the global market. So it was very much oriented towards the trade in goods.This had an enormous positive effect on China because it employed a lot of people, helped their export earnings and so forth. The new pilot free trade zone in Shanghai, I believe, is much more focused on facilitating the outflow of capital from China. And most of the firms that have registered in the Shanghai free trade zone have been domestic firms by a very wide margin rather than foreign firms. Because if you register there and set up a premise and start doing business there,you can do more things than you could if you were not in the zone. Some of them are importing goods duty-free and then selling them via the internet into the domestic market.
Uncovering the truth.
We are on our way to Leari, one of the most dangerous districts in the city of Karachi.
We were told that we're just about to cross the border between Malaysia and the Philippines.
Going the distance to get the story. We meet the real people with real hope.
For many young Thais, Muay Thai is one of the only ways to lift their families out of poverty.
Behind every corner is a great story. Assignment Asia. Expect the unexpected.
The China-Shanghai Free Trade Zone is part of China's reform, but yet there's a lot of misunderstanding and uncertainty internationally, but also in China. So let's begin by understanding the basic principles behind the free trade zone.
我们平常碰到的最常见的这个对自贸区的一些错误的理解呢，一个是人家问自由贸易试验区里是不是免税区，因为有一些自由贸易区它是免税区，但是上海自由贸易区它是既包括保税区也包括非保税区，所以不能按照这个税收包括关税和一些国内税收的免除作为自由贸易试验区的一个标志。还有一种误解呢，是叫做特殊的政策区域，也就是说在我们自贸试验区里不受国内的其他的政策的监管。这个呢不完全是这样，因为除了我们已经明确的政策调整措施以外，我们区内和区外执行的政策呢应该是一致的。
Why would a company come here? What type of company would take advantage of the policies that you have?
因为自贸试验区就推出了一系列的改革措施，涉及到投资、贸易、金融以及政府部门自身的事中事后监管的各个方面，所以这些政策措施呢都受到了市场的广泛关注。从我们企业注册的类型来看呢，我们的贸易企业、投资类企业和金融服务类企业是比较集中的。我们这边的这个中小企业现在占我们自贸试验区里新注册企业的80%以上，就是这些中小企业它的新业务它愿意在自贸试验区来试。同时呢，我们这个海外投资数量是从无到有，就是原来在自贸试验区设立之前，这个海外投资一般不从这个自贸试验区的这个平台上走的，现在我们设立自贸试验区了以后，我们数量增长的非常快，目前已经占到上海市海外投资的数量的50%以上。所以说这样子呢，主要是我们提供了这样的一个与国际接轨的制度环境。
What's the difference of the inbound and outbound investments in the free trade zone versus other places in China?
对于外国投资，也就是说从国外到我们国内的这个投资来说呢，自贸试验区里采用了一个崭新的制度，也是负面清单的管理模式。那么就是改变了原来的外商投资逐案审批的这样的一个管理模式，外资管理的效率大幅提高。举个例子，原来我们在外资审批的时候，国家规定的法定的审批时限是20个工作日，上海自我加压是在8个工作日内完成审批。但是如果是按照自贸试验区的负面清单的管理模式，由企业自主的完成备案手续，实际上可以在1天以内，甚至可以当场就完成。
Wan Chaoling works for a medical company in the Shanghai Free Trade Zone. Her main duty is to oversee customs clearing for the company's imports. Of these, the most complex the process is a diagnostic reagent for lung cancer.
One document for one permit was almost half as thick as this because it included all the product ingredients and the registration information.
It used to take about 10 days to move the reagent from the manufacturer to the port of destination. And the import regulator required 20 working days to process biomedical imports like this. That means a month had already passed by the time the reagent arrived at the hospital. And this kind of reagent usually only has a shelf life of 3 months.
The shelf life of some of our reagents is quite short. People might think that it's very challenging for us to import these reagents.
Some of the reagents have a shelf life of only 10 days. Some can lose effect even before they're imported.And in a public emergency, the need for these reagents shoots up immediately. Enterprises and regulators had a lot of arguments on how to improve the efficiency. Then the import regulator started to use IT and underwent training to adapt to the changes.
We used the internet to develop software and process the approval. This spares enterprises a lot of trouble. If they have access to the internet, they can submit applications for administrative licensing and check the progress online.
The approval process has now been shortened from 20 working days to 5, a major change for imports of lung cancer reagents.
We started the entry application on the 21st of July and finished by the 22nd of July.
With this new policy, medical enterprises now have much more flexibility. Our R&D departments now have more resources to develop products. More importantly, it's in line with international practice.
那么对于海外投资，也就是外向型的投资， 那么我们自贸试验区里率先实施了备案管理的制度，也就是说，原来我们很不管什么企业到海外投资，也是要经过层层审批，甚至到国家的有关部门去审批的。那么在自贸试验区里，通过自贸试验区里设置一个平台公司，然后再从这个平台公司作为海外投资的话，那么也是实行备案制。所以这两种备案制的话，就把大家的投资的热情激发了。
外商呢，他认为呢，就是我们的负面清单。 从13年、14年到15年，尽管我们是在改进，我们那个越来越短，但是呢，他还是感到呢，就是我们的开放度还不够，但是我们是一个单方面的主动的开放，我的开放时间表，我的开放的一些领域等等，一方面要根据外商的一些需求，但是另外一方面还要根据我的国家利益，我的整个经济发展的一个。
一个水平和情况，负面清单本来是用于国际投资的，但是呢，实际上在我们国家，负面清单已经成为我们市场化改革的一项政策的工具。十八届三中全会的决定里面，它对负面清单有两处的描述，一个是对外国投资实行准入权国民待遇加负面清单的管理模式，一个呢是在国内实施各类投资主体均等准入的负面清单制度。 所以说，如果有了负面清单这样的一个制度的话，我们就可以把这个政府的职责边界划得更清楚，那么会反过来就会更加鼓励市场的创新。Give
me some examples of companies, if you can name them, fine. If not, generally what they do and how they have taken advantage of the free trade zone. What are some specific examples?
我举个例子，这个企业最关心的是自贸试验区里的金融，就是说他们讲到自贸试验区里来。 运作是不是可以，在融资方面降低企业的成本，这一方面呢是肯定的。我们自贸试验区里，创设了一个叫做自由贸易账户这样的一个基础的金融改革的一个工具。那么通过这个自由贸易账户，我们就可以实现在这个账户里面，就是人民币和外币的完全的可兑换。
上海自贸试验区和其他三家自贸试验区一个最大的。 一个或者说是一个特点，就是，国际化，那个金融中心是在上海市，其他几家自贸区呢，它没有这个功能。一方面，它是金融制度创新。所谓金融制度创新呢，它就是它的一个中心环节，就是人民币资本项目可兑换。因为那个人民币呢，它的经常项目它已经。 很早就可以兑换了，在现在我们最后几个环节就是推进资本项目可兑换，而资本项目可兑换它直接对应的就是人民币的国际化使用，那么这一点呢，就是明确在上海自贸区里面是资本项目可兑换呢，按照国际货币基金组织的定义的话，它分成40种，就是说我们国家的资本项目可兑换的目前的进展已经85%都是可以可兑换的。 我们剩下的一部分主要是集中在这个资本市场下面的资本项目的可兑换的问题，所以说上海现在所推行的这些自由贸易账户也好啦，跟我们的国际国内市场资本市场的连接也好，都是向着这个资本项目可兑换的最后一步在迈进。
And some financial liberalization is occurring first in this new Shanghai pilot zone. For example, In 2015, the government introduced so-called certificates of deposit, which are floating rate deposits. They're very large scale. For an individual, you have to invest 300,000 RMB. For a corporation, you have to invest 10 million. And these will offer higher returns than alternative financial products. But you have to be registered in the zone to purchase these kinds of products. It's part of the liberalization of the financial sector. And in some respects, it's very similar to what China's done with other kinds of reforms. They try it out in a limited geographic area, see how it goes, what are the problems, what are the benefits. Eventually, if they think it's working, they will expand this, and Chinese firms anywhere will be able to buy these certificates of deposit and domestic residents as well.
Tell me some of the complaints that you've had. I'm sure not everybody is happy with everything. As an official, you probably hear some complaints from some companies. What are some of them?
我们经常遇到的企业会提出的问题呢, 就是第一个,融资的规模太小, 他们觉得他们希望能够在自贸试验区里大幅度降低他们的这个融资的成本, 就是因为现在国外的很多利率, 尤其是 QE政策的推出以后呢, 很多的利率非常低, 跟我们人民币的国内的这个利率水平比起来, 那是非常低的。 其实这个方面呢, 我们已经做了明显的改进, 就是我们自由贸易账户对外融资, 刚开始的时候只能融你注册资本的一倍, 现在我们就可以融两倍了, 而且在特殊的领域, 如果你是用在贸易方面呢, 你的融资还不受限制, 所以说这方面呢, 我们改进的也是非常快。 比方说呢, 还有人, 就是希望呢, 就是我们 自贸试验区里的税收制度进一步的优化, 尤其是在海外投资的税收制度方面与国际接轨。 为什么呢? 就是说如果一个企业在海外投资, 那么它面临的竞争不是你国内的环境, 它面临的是国际市场的竞争。 我们国家有关部门呢, 已经做了大量的调研工作, 我们在推进一个具有国际竞争力的海外投资的和离岸业务的税收制度的建设。 所以呢, 我觉得 企业提出的需求实际上就是我们下一步改革的动力和方向所在。
From emerging powers to expanding partnerships, from fighting poverty to combating climate change, booming economies, war-ravaged nations, and everything in between. We capture the changes affecting the most dynamic and diverse continent on the planet, taking you beyond the headlines to the people and their stories. Asia Today, delivering Asia to the world.
We now have three new free trade zones in China, in Guangdong, in Fujian, in Tianjin. So let's start by saying, as vice director of the Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone, what advice would you give to your peers and your counterparts in Guangdong, Fujian, and Tianjin?
那么如果说我们多干了一年半, 那么我们对他们有些什么经验的来说呢, 我们觉得呢, 就是这一方面很重要, 也就是说, 是沟通和协调, 这一方面是很重要, 因为刚才, 你也说了, 就是说我们有很, 我们现在改革的是一个政策体系, 而政策体系涉及的方方面面是非常多的, 所以说这一方面沟通和协调能力, 无论是跟政府部门的沟通, 还是跟我们市场力量的沟通，这个一定要做得非常充分，而且要花大量的精力。
But in fact, if companies get the benefit of a free trade zone, they're only going to register in one. They don't have to register in four, I don't think. So there is going to be a competition within China between the different free trade zones.
对啊，竞争是一个好东西，竞争会产生激励，会产生动力。所以说，我想一个企业它决定在哪一个自贸试验区里开展它的业务，取决于这个自贸试验区里给它提供的综合的制度环境，而并不只是一项或者两项的特殊的政策。因为一个企业它要正常的运作，它所面临的是一个方方面面，不仅是有政府，可能甚至有第三方的市场力量一起来做一下这样的环境。所以我们上海呢，就是希望能够用一个高标准的规则去打造一个有利于企业发展的国际化的环境。
What could be the obstacles that would inhibit you from achieving these goals?
我们觉得最大的一个障碍呢，是这个认识的差异性。就是说，对于我们这个下一步的改革开放的这个目标和重点，那么我们有自己的体会，但是不同的区域有它不同的体会，或者是不同的层级有它不同的观点。所以说，如果是最大的障碍就是说要沟通，所以我刚才也对这个沟通协调呢也是非常强调的。如果我们上海世贸试验区的试验越成功，影响越大，产生的效果越好，那么越能够产生共识，越能够降低我们沟通的障碍。
For China to deepen reform means for China to continue its transformation from a planned economy to a market-oriented economy. The results of these reforms reduce powers of government and enhance rights of individuals to do things in their own best interests. When individuals prosper, society prospers. Since it was established in 2013, the China-Shanghai Pilot Free Trade Zone has carried out institutional innovation in areas of investment, foreign trade, finance, and supervision, primarily by simplifying processes and reducing restrictions for doing business. The FTZ has adopted a so-called negative list to streamline investments, simplify foreign trade regulations, and promote financial system reform to realize RMB capital account convertibility and to facilitate trade financing. China's pilot FTZs have now expanded to include Guangdong, Fujian, and Tianjin. But more reform is needed, especially financial liberalization and shrinking those negative lists. To appreciate how China tests new policies, assesses real-world results, and only when new policies work expands their application, is to be closer to China.